Good morning, everyone. Hope you're doing well. Hope you're doing good. So today is a back day. It's a pull day. So we're going to be doing deadlifts. We're going to be doing rows. And we're going to be doing a lot of heavy lifting. So I hope you enjoy the session. I'll show it to you in a minute. But first off, I want to talk about some general stuff. So mind the stuff in the background because my life has been crazy recently. You might notice on Instagram that I've been a lot more active. If you haven't followed me on Instagram, go follow me out here. I've been posting every day, been posting my story quite often as well. So definitely check me out there if you haven't seen my Instagram before, as I'm being a lot more active on it, and you'll probably see a lot more lifestyle stuff from me on there. So the stuff I want to talk about is all related to the fact that I'm going to be leaving Cornwall soon. I've got 8 days, I think, until I've left Cornwall, and I moved back to London, where obviously the situation of lockdown and the COVID is a lot worse up there. So I don't know if the gym will be open, or I don't know if I'm going to be able to train. I don't know if I'm going to have time to train or a place to train, or anything training wise up there. And obviously lockdown might really come, great wording. But that being said, that's a lot more stress on my shoulders knowing that I might not have training again after just recently getting it back. Obviously I'm gonna try my best to find a gym up there. If I haven't found one, I'll keep trying. I can travel a good hour anywhere around London just to find a gym. So if you guys know anywhere in London that's still open, let me know, that'd be greatly appreciated. But the reason I'm telling you this is just because I'm gonna explain how crazy my life's gonna be, because right now I've got to pack, I've got to get ready for uni. Even though I don't even know if my uni's gonna be open yet, I've still got to get ready for it. I've still got to plan out everything. So content might be a little bit limited on my channel. So Instagram is probably definitely the best place to find me or to message me. If you have anything private to message me over there. And if you want to see more content, probably over there, because it's easier to put up a post. It's very easy to take a photo and just put it up there. I explain some stuff with it. But it also leads me on to the fact that my content will be getting better, hopefully. I have my own flat, so I'll be able to record more. So these next 2 weeks might be a struggle, but once I'm there and once we're all sorted, it's gonna be a lot easier and a lot more content is gonna be coming out from this channel. And it's also hopefully gonna be better as the equipment will be getting better, the flat will be better, the place will look cleaner, and everything will be much easier and simpler for me to make a video and to record some content. So the next topic I want to talk about is me and my actual training myself. So as you guys know, I was cutting down at the right beginning of this channel. I literally made this channel starting off with my cutting videos. But right now, having these couple of weeks just to train in a gym again, I've upped my calories back to 3,000. I'm eating a lot more, I'm training a lot more. And when I am training heavy, I'm getting starving, I feel hungry. So most days I'm going over that 3,000 calorie threshold, because I'm having to need it for the recovery. But to be fair with me, my body's doing well. I actually think my body's looking better with the food in it and the heavier weights in it than it did actually when I was trying to lose weight. So it's all good that way, but I'm just hoping that I don't lose the gyms again. And I'm hoping that in London I can find a place, I can still train, I can still eat, and everything can continue that way. So yeah, a few crazy weeks. Stuff definitely been going well, like my gym and my training's definitely gone well. There's been packing to do, there's been sorting out flat stuff to do, a lot of messing around, a lot more content coming out on Instagram, but not so much on YouTube, so yeah, swings and roundabouts. But with that being said, let's get to this training session, and I hope you enjoy. And I'll see you guys afterwards.
Right, so we're down here, all on our own, no one else here, so it's a lovely time to train. We've already done one exercise, and that was pull downs, so the cable's just putting it down, trying to activate the lats. We're now starting off with deadlifts. I've already done a warm-up set. We're gonna work up a little bit more, put on some more plates. Have a nice little slow warm-up because my lower back is the worst part of my back. So I don't wanna overload it too quick, too soon. So we're just gonna put on 10s, 20s, and so on until we're nice and warm. And then we'll go with a top set with probably about 180, maybe 200. So we'll see how good it is. It has been a while since we've deadlifted, so let's see how it goes. Also, don't judge the beater or the trousers. I've literally packed every single item of my clothing I've left for this. So, it's the best we can do. So deadlifts, I always go touch and go tactic, because doing it when you pause at the bottom and then having to lift again is
great if you're a powerlifter and you're trying to lift a weight. But as a bodybuilder, we just want to keep our muscles under tension. We want to keep them activated. We want to get as much volume and reps in as possible. If you're trying to do touch and go, it's obviously going to work better because that touch and go giving you a little leeway of that bounce at the bottom. And the bottom bit is always the hardest part. When you're trying to pull off the floor, that's the hardest part of the first 3 or 4 inches. We can get a little bit of bounce. We've missed that 3 or 4 inches. We've only got the whole rest of the motion that our back's working, that our hamstring's working, that the glutes are working. So we've missed that hardest part. We're pretty much nailing that exercise and we're making it more functional for a bodybuilding purpose instead of a powerlifting purpose. So we're at 150 right now. Oh, I shut some just because my forearm grip sucks. So 155 was easy. We're gonna move up. I'm saying 155, I'm not sure if the bar is a 25 or 20. But either way, add the weight either side. We're gonna move up into the actual workout set. Workout set. That was my top set, 165 for 4, which is awful, but now that I think about it, I haven't deadlifted in 8 months, so 165 for 4 is not a bad starting point. It's actually killed me. And I hit 125 for 10 afterwards, which was much harder than the actual top set. And it's got me out of breath. We got dumbbell rows next, then a pull down. And then from then on, it's rear delt stuff and bicep stuff. So let's get these next two hard movements going and then we can relax a little because I'm dying. Guys, welcome. So the workout's done, nice back workout. Obviously a little bit disappointed with the weight I was lifting, but it felt really good. Definitely got a good back pump, definitely got a good feeling from it, and hopefully there's gonna be good growth from it. Also hopefully deadlift session next week will be a lot heavier, because 165 is awful for what I used to be pulling. I used to be able to pull 210, 200, 165 is quite a lot of drop. So that's about 50 kilo drop in 10 months, which I guess is fair enough. So hopefully we can build it back up quite quick. Now you might have noticed behind me that most of the stuff on that desk is gone, and that's because we've actually finished packing. So today is the day before we go. So the next video you see is either go into London or in London. So with that being said, I'm going to finish off packing, I'm going to finish off everything else. I'll see you guys in the next video and hopefully in London. Peace.